Wilson, and I'm the chair for the Wilson School of Nursing. On behalf of the Robert D. and Carol Gunn College of Health Sciences and Human Services and the faculty and staff of the Wilson School of Nursing, I'd like to welcome all of you and every guest to this fall 2016 nursing pinning ceremony. Dr. James Johnson is in the office. He is the dean of the college, the Gunn College of Health Sciences and Human Services, and he is with us this evening. We appreciate the support and guidance he gives to this nursing program. He is truly a leader who, through his innovative spirit and encouragement, will continue to propel our school and college forward. We welcome all the families and friends who have joined us for this celebration. Thank you for supporting our graduates. Your guidance and support has helped them pursue their dreams of being a nurse. At this time, would all the Wilson School of Nursing faculty and staff in the audience please stand? And yes, we are no longer at work. And thank you to all those individuals who have tirelessly worked with all the students. This evening's pinning ceremony signifies the completion of your studies and moves you towards your goal of being a registered nurse. And tomorrow's graduation, and you will receive your diploma and become an alumni of Midwestern State University. To as you engage in all these evenings activities and graduation tomorrow is believe in the power that you have in yourself to advance the science and art of nursing. Believe in the power of nursing is that as nurses we are truly extraordinary. Congratulations on this significant event and thank you all for coming tonight. Enjoy this celebration as we welcome our new graduates into the profession of nursing. Thank you.
For the love and support. I really appreciate it. It means a lot. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the fall 2016 MSU Wilson School of Nursing pinning ceremony. On behalf of my fellow graduates, I personally want to thank everyone for being here and the celebration, love, and support of these graduates right in front of me. Also, we want to thank the people that couldn't make it here this evening for their continued love and support. A big thanks to First Baptist Church for the pleasure of letting us have a nursing pinning ceremony here this evening. Another big thanks to the faculty and staff, fellow nursing students, and nursing graduates for volunteering their time in order to make this nursing pinning ceremony a success. I would personally like to give a special adoration to Professor Distel for our dedication and effort in making this and previous nursing ceremonies a success. As this is almost her last nursing pinning ceremony, Professor Distel will be retiring next year, and we are honored to have had her as a leader, educator, and nurse for the MSU Wilson School of Nursing. Let's give her a huge warm round of applause. We love you, Professor Distel.
Thank you.
On behalf of my fellow classmates, we're grateful for the faculty and staff in the classroom and clinical and the Stimulation Center for their passion and duty to the nursing profession. We appreciate that you taught us so many aspects of nursing, and for that, we'll become the nurses that you envisioned us to be. For instance, Professor Lockhart taught us this semester that we have to clean our wounds before we obtain a culture to test for bacteria. And Ron has taught us that babies really do like breastfeeding. show gratitude to Midwestern State University and the healthcare agencies of the community for giving us opportunity to enrich our minds and hearts for the nursing profession and giving us venues and providing great patient care. To my fellow classmates, Professor Lockhart is giving us course activity points for just getting in and graduating. Isn't that great? I wish nursing school was that easy, but it's been quite the opposite. This has been great, but arduous journey for us. I'm beyond grateful and proud of each and every one of you for working hard and never giving up, despite everyone having senioritis at the beginning of the nursing program. I hope that you take what you have learned to impact so many lives, now and in the near future. Now, at this time, if you prefer to do so, I would like to ask everyone to stand and bow your heads for a time of reflection and prayer. Lord, we are grateful for every breathing second in our lives. We express gratitude for your existence in our daily lives. We thank you for the abundant blessings in our lives. Continue to mold us so that we become disciples in your name. Thank you for your love that is patient, kind, and powerful, so that we love others as we love ourselves. Holy Father, we thank you for the family and friends in our lives, for their gracious affection and continuing inspiration in good times and in bad. Lord, bless First Baptist Church, Midwestern State University, and these healthcare agencies, and that these institutions continue to make a positive impact in people's lives. Thank you, Lord, for the nursing profession and guiding each of us in the path of nursing. Father, thank you for the unforgettable memories made during nursing school, and we are grateful for your strength as we have completed our journey. Continue to give each and every one of us tenacity in times of great need. As my fellow classmates and I give pen this evening, I pray that you empower us with love, kindness, bravery, charity, and authority as we enter into the nursing workforce. Lead us with great knowledge of truth so that we are capable of doing the most for our patients. I pray that everyone will live their lives by faith and not by sight. For the world, I pray for peace and that we come together as brothers and sisters despite our differences, as our love will conquer hate now and forever. In your name we pray. Amen. Thank you very much. Please be seated and enjoy the rest of the ceremony.
Heaven makes sense to you and it's time. education doesn't cease outside of the classroom, nor should it. Being an educator is more about just speaking facts to an audience of students. It is about sharing a bond with your class and being excited for even the smallest breakthrough in retaining the material. Our speaker tonight is one of our most highly thought of professors. She is known and respected for her kind nature and warm encouragement. She reinforces her teachings in the classroom with an open door for questions and guidance. Her lighthearted teaching style and sheer passion for our success has made her so valuable to each of us throughout our progression in this program. It is refreshing to be taught by a woman who wishes nothing more than to see her students thrive and bring wisdom and knowledge to the nursing profession. It is educators like her who will truly have an impact on our future. You may not know it, but you have etched a permanent mark in all 71 graduates, and for that we are all grateful. On the behalf of my class, I would like to introduce Professor Stephanie Baker to the stage.
Of defense for a patient, and it's your job to think critically about the situation.
I've thought a lot about what other questions you could ask to ensure your success, so here are some suggestions. Always ask, will you help me? As a nurse, it's crucial to ask for help, whether it involves double-checking a dosage calculation or getting assistance in transferring a patient. Knowing when to ask for help is important in maintaining patient safety as well as your own. Asking for help is not a sign of weakness. It's a sign of courage and a commitment to a job well done. The next question is, how can I help you? Nursing is a team sport, and even more so, quality healthcare requires a team effort. But nurses are the foundation of healthcare, and we have the power to set the tone to ensure better outcomes for our patients. There's no such thing as that's not my patient or that's not my job. Whether it's your first day on the floor or your last day of a 40-plus year career, I hope you never stop helping when you have the opportunity to do so. And finally, is there anything more I can do? Yes, in very simple terms. Asking your patient this question might save you a few extra trips to the med room or to the snack room. But truly, this is the foundation of nursing. In your future as a nurse, I can promise you that you will be an important part of a meaningful event in your patients' lives. Sometimes those moments are at the happiest times, but more often than not, in the hardest moment of someone's life, it's the nurse that's there to offer support when it matters most. As a nurse, some days will be amazing, but other days will be challenging. At the end of those difficult days, take comfort in knowing that you diligently and compassionately provided care. So I know we've asked you to remember a lot over the last few years, but please keep these four questions in the back of your mind. Number one, always ask why. Number two, ask, will you help me? Three, how can I help you? And four, is there anything more I can do? So speaking of more, I have one more thing. Earlier I spoke about how thinking like a nurse must become second nature. So can you guess how I prepared for this speech tonight? I used the nursing process. Did you catch it? Assessment, history, okay, you got it. Okay. Class, always remember that this process is a continuous and evolving approach to answering almost anything that life throws your way. Whenever presented with something new, always start with assessment. And after your long journey of the Bachelor's of Science in Nursing program at Midwestern State University, be proud and reflect how far you've come. Can you believe it? You did it. And from the bottom of my heart, I am so proud of you. Congratulations.
Bye. to thank God for how far he has brought me. A big thank you to my parents, siblings, and all of my family and friends for their constant prayers and support. A special thank you to my best friend, Nellie, for being there for me and her encouraging words throughout these tough years. Love you all.
Christine Michelle Arondo. Christine is being
pushing me to be my best. I could not have done it without y'all. And thank you, Ricky, for being my backbone throughout our nursing school journey together and sharing this great moment with me. Love y'all. For putting up with me and my dumb jokes. I would also like to thank my family for their continued support, both financially and emotionally. I definitely could not have done this without you. You have no idea how much I appreciate everything you've done for me. I love you all more than air. And Tiffany has accepted a graduate nurse position in post-anesthesia care unit at Texoma Medical Center in Denison.
Our next graduate is Ms. Leanne Simone Brooks, and she'll be pinned tonight by Pastor and Mrs. David Youngblood, spiritual mentors, and Professor Mary Jo Distel. She would like to say that another challenge conquered by the grace of God. To those who helped me along this journey, thank yous go to my parents for their boundless love, my husband and children for helping me find my strength to keep going. Malachi, you are the biggest reminder that I can do all things through Christ. Special thanks to my professors for their assistance and my church family for their support. God bless you all.
Express to you how thankful I am for you and your undying support and love through these stressful few years. I wouldn't be here without you. Thank you for being my strength and motivation through all the ups and downs. I love you both more than you can possibly know, and I am so blessed to have you as my parents. Next, I present Laura Evans. Laura is being pinned tonight by her husband, Brian Evans. Lauren is blessed to be the mother of three wonderful children and a wife to the most supportive husband on earth. Above all, she would like to thank God from whom all blessings flow. She also would like to thank her husband, family, and friends for their prayers and support to help her achieve this dream. Laura is being presented with a plaque of appreciation for serving as an SNA senator. She also has been accepted into an RN residency program at Weiss Health System in Decatur. Department internship program. Our next graduate is Alexandria Garcia. Alexandria is being pinned tonight by her father, Joe Westbrook. And she says, I want to thank my family for their continuous support. Words cannot express my gratitude. I also want to thank God for continually guiding me on this journey. I look forward to my new career in nursing. And Alex is going into a progressive care unit internship at the Baylor Park Hospital in Plano. When I didn't think I could go on. You instilled in me the values and morals needed to become the best person and nurse I can be. This is not just my victory, because without all of you, this journey would not have been possible. School of Nursing professor. And Carrie says, I would like to extend a special thank you to my family, friends, and professors for encouraging me through this journey. I owe this accomplishment and future success to the Lord, and am looking forward to what is to come. And Carrie has accepted a trauma team position at OU Medical Center in Oklahoma City, Oklahoma. From our program in 2014. And Jay says, I would like to thank my family and friends. I am who I am today because of your love, guidance, and support. I am so lucky to have such a wonderful support system around me, and I could not have done this without all of you. I would also like to thank the MSU nursing professors and staff for helping us succeed in our journey to become nurses. And Jay is going into an immersion residency program at St. David's South Austin Medical Center. Next, I present Caitlin Nicole Hoffbauer. Caitlin is being pinned tonight by her parents, Don and Valerie Hoffbauer. And she says, I would like to thank my parents for all of their sacrifices throughout the years. Without each of you, I'd be nowhere near the person I am and the person I'm still working on becoming. There aren't enough words in the world to express my appreciation. Thank you both for never giving up on me. And Caitlin is going to the Palmetto Health's Emergency Room Level 1 Trauma Center Residency Program in Columbia, South Carolina. Okay, now I need to say this name very slowly. This is Gentile Iridukunda. And she's being pinned tonight by her dad, Faustin Natamushobora, and her mom, Salome Mukandutia. And Gentile says, to God be the glory for how far I have come. Dad, Mom, Mu, Pesh, Aaron, Paul, Letty, and Peter, I know y'all's knees are sore from all the kneeling while praying, and I love y'all so much. Thank you to my extended family and my church family. Last but definitely not the least, thank you to my teachers and my classmates, especially my BFFs, Florence, Rose, and Haja. Y'all rock my socks, literally. Gentile is going to John Peter Smith in Fort Worth into their residency program. Our next graduate is Melinda Brett Johnson. Melinda is being pinned tonight by her parents, Brett and Molly Johnson. Melinda says, Mom and Dad, I am so blessed to have you as your steadfast. I'm so blessed to have had your steadfast love and encouragement as I pursued this dream. Thank you for teaching me how to love others, work hard, and how to succeed according to Colossians 3:23, which says, whatever you do, work at it with all your heart as working for the Lord and not for man. And Melinda has been accepted into the Cook Children's Pediatric Nurse Residency Program. Next, I'd like to present Meg Jones. Meg is being pinned tonight by her father, David Jones, and her mother, Carol Jones. Meg is graduating cum laude from MSU and the Wilson School of Nursing. She was involved in Chi Omega Sorority, Sigma Theta Tau Nursing Honor Society, and Alpha Chi Honor Society. She would like to thank her family and friends for helping her get here today. And Meg has accepted a residency program at Methodist Health System in Mansfield in the emergency department. Next, I present Clement Hanadu. Clement is being pinned tonight by his friend, Rebecca Opoku. And Clement says, I thank God for giving me strength to pass through all the obstacles in my nursing program. It wouldn't be possible without God. Also, I appreciate each and everyone who gave me strength throughout the program. Friends and family members who have been there for me. This success is not only for me, it belongs to us. Thank you, and God bless my closest classmates as well. Our next graduate is Yoni Lombay.
Jeter.
Yoni says, I want to say thank you to Jesus for your grace and strength that enabled me to complete nursing school. I would also love to thank the Lambie family, Kimball's, Jeter's, my pastors, and my church family for their financial, moral, and spiritual support. Thanks, too, to the Wilson School of Nursing faculty and staff. I wouldn't have done this without you all. And he hasn't accepted a position yet. Next, I present Kimberly Sue Leitner. Kimberly is being pinned tonight by her grandfather, Paul Leitner, and her mother, Susie Leitner. Kimberly says, today I finally get to be pinned, and tomorrow I will graduate from nursing school. All the sleepless nights, happy times, and meltdowns of not so happy times. I made it through by the grace of God and with the constant love and unlimited support given by my family and friends. Words can never express the gratitude I have. I love you guys. And Kimberly has accepted a staff nurse position in pediatrics at Baptist St. Anthony's in Amarillo. Our next graduate is Natalia Nicole Resto Lopez. Achievement of my life. This incredible journey of the last 2.5 years at MSU, which culminates in this beautiful moment today, would not have been possible without the help and support of my loving family and friends. I would like to thank my parents, my brother, sister-in-law, uncle, and auntie for all their support and motivation. My friend Lula, for having shared many special memories together. And finally, to my partner in crime, my dear sister Tulsi, an MSU nursing graduate herself, for always believing in me. Having a sister like you makes me a better person every day. Next, I present Raya Marquise. Raya is being pinned tonight by her husband, Ethan Marquise. And Raya says, may all the glory go to God. I would not have gotten here today without his guidance and unfailing love. I would like to say thank you to my wonderful husband for his encouragement and unwavering support throughout this journey. Also to my mom and dad, thank you for your unconditional love, support, and direction. You are both my inspiration and the reason behind why I push myself to be the best that I can be always. And Raya has accepted a position at United Regional here in Wichita Falls on 9 West, which is a progressive care unit. Next is Shelby Elizabeth McGuffin. Shelby is being pinned tonight by her parents, Mark and Tammy McGuffin. And Shelby says, sadly, the long nights and pizza deliveries to the library have come to an end, but not the friendships I've made over the past 2.5 years. I want to express a special thanks to my parents who have put up with their completely stressed out daughter. I would not be where I am today without the support of my amazing family and friends. And Shelby has been accepted into an emergency department residency program at Texas Health Southwest in Fort Worth. Our next graduate is Samantha Brooks Miller. Samantha is being pinned tonight by her mother, Shelley Miller, and her father, Bob Miller. And Sam would like to say thank you to her friends and family here tonight for all their love and support throughout this journey of hers. But most importantly, Sam would like to thank her, Mana, and Granddad for their utmost generosity, helping make her future as a nurse possible. And she said, now that this chapter has come to an end, it's back to Dallas for Sam. Having passion for many specialties in the nursing field, she's still undecided for which path she might take, but things will fall into place. Our next graduate is Kristen Kathleen Muncy. Kristen is being pinned tonight by her parents, David and Kathy Muncy. And she says, I would like to thank my family and friends for all the support and love they provided throughout these years. I could not have made it through nursing school without them. I also want to thank my professors and nursing preceptors for my education. I hope to make you all proud as I begin my career. Smiley face. And she has been accepted at United Regional's internship program in the emergency room here in Wichita Falls. Next, I present Amber Nicole Mulcahy. Amber is being pinned tonight by her husband Kevin and her sons Nicholas and Christopher Mulcahy. And she says, what a journey. From the first day of classes to this, pinning, a day I thought would never come. Thank you to my husband for pushing me when I wanted to quit, to my children who had a little less mommy, to my mom, best friends, Autumn and Valentina, and to my other friends, family, and faculty who told me I could do this. Thank you all. And Amber is being presented a plaque of appreciation. appreciation for serving as an SNA senator. And she has also accepted a staff nurse position on 4 West, which is a medical surgical unit here at United Regional in Wichita Falls. And she's got her hands full at home, I can tell. Next, I present Sarah Ashley Myers. Sarah is being picked by her mother and mentor, Susan Ann Myers, RN. And Sarah says, "Thank you to my loved ones for their continued patience and support, but mostly their patience. It's been a long road. Thank you, Dad, for always being there to talk when I needed it. Thank you to my mother, who always pushes me to do better and whom I have great respect for. I am finally off the payroll, Mom." And she's being presented a plaque of appreciation for serving as an absolutely awesome SNA president. And Sarah has accepted a position at the emergency department at Cal West Regional Hospital. Sarah Elise Nauman. She's being pinned tonight by her parents, Lois and Charles Nauman. And Sarah says, "The day has finally come, and I cannot believe it. It would not have been possible without my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, and the people he has blessed me with. I would like to thank my mom and dad, Matthew, Greg, Ashley, Doug, and Jenny, and my BSM family for y'all's never-ending support. Y'all continually encouraged and prayed for me throughout this challenging journey, and I am thankful beyond what words can express. Congratulations, class of fall 2016. We made it." huge thank you to my family and friends. This has been a long, challenging journey for all of us. I want you all to know that I appreciate each and every one of you. All of you have contributed to my success. To my mother, I would like to give special thank you for being so kind and supportive. Lastly, I want to say thank you to the faculty of Wilson School of Nursing. Next, I present Samuel Wagboso. Samuel is being pinned tonight by his daughter, Rachel. And Samuel says, if I have flown any higher than my dreams, it has been on the borrowed wings of divinity, my precious family, and my friends. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for by you I have advanced against a troop. And by my God, I have leaped over a wall. You've caused my lamp to light and to shine. Psalm 18:29. Class of fall 2016, we made it. Now it's on to us to be worthy ambassadors of this great institution wherever we find ourselves. And Samuel has been accepted into an ICU internship at Baylor Scott & White. Next, I present Florence B. Ogaro. She's being pinned tonight by her husband, Daniel Atombo, and by her pastor, Leiba Masese. And Florence says, first, I thank our Almighty God for blessing me this far. I give special thanks to my wonderful husband, Dan, for cheering when I pass and encouraging me in all of my nursing school years. You took care of our children, and you gave humble time to study. Special thanks to Pastor Leiba, Sandra, Ruth, and Eugene for being my prayer warriors. And Florence has accepted a graduate nurse position at Texas Health Resources, HEB Hospital in Bedford, Texas, as an orthopedic nurse. Speak slowly. Our next graduate is beautiful Oluwadamelola Ogundare. And she's being pinned tonight by her mother, Olamide Ogundare and Badadren. And she says, notice I said she says, I just want to give glory to God for seeing me through the toughest 2.5 years of my life. I wouldn't have been able to make it without the support of my loving parents, my brother Alex, Reuben, and family and friends. Never give up on your dreams, and I am living testimony of what God can do. And she has accepted a graduate nurse position in labor and delivery at Texas Health Resources in Allen. Wouldn't have been possible without my team, dad, mom, and siblings. things. I want to say thank you for constantly pushing me and always believing in me. Most importantly, my praise goes to my Heavenly Father for seeing me through. And she quotes 2 Timothy 4:7, I have fought the good fight, I have finished the race, and I have kept the faith. Our next graduate is Skylar Lynn Patterson. She's being pinned tonight by her parents, Sherry and Woody Patterson. And Skylar says to my family, friends, and coworkers, thank you for being a solid foundation for me to grow and succeed on during my nursing journey. Thank you for the constant love and unrelenting support throughout the years. Thank you for assisting me in transforming my dreams into reality. If I haven't said it enough already, thank you, thank you, thank you, because without y'all, I would not be here today.
Who continuously reminded me of the reason I started this journey.
I would like to thank my family and friends for all the emotional and physical support you gave me through this journey. I look forward to starting my career as a nurse. And Shamara is going to be a school nurse at Louisville Independent School District in Louisville, Texas. Schooling is finally here, and my heart is overfilled with joy. First of all, I thank God for giving me the strength and knowledge I needed every step of the way. Thank you to my family and friends for their continual support, love, and guidance in all of my endeavors. This accomplishment is for my family and friends, especially for you, Mommy and Poppy. And Diana, it has been accepted into an emergency department residency program at Baylor Scott & White in Irving. Next, I present Rhea Rindava. Rhea is being met by her mother, Debbie, and by her brother, Udinya Rindava. And Rhea says, I would like to thank God for guiding me through this journey of daily emotional roller coasters and for blessing me with the best parents and siblings that anyone could ask for. I am grateful to my mom, who is my confidant and whom I could go to for anything, and to my dad for being proud of me and supporting me both emotionally and financially. Sister Luz Lopez Shep and by her brother-in-law Deepak Shep. Natalia says, I'm so blessed to be where I am today. I could not have done this without the support of my sweet, prayerful mother, encouraging sister and brother-in-law, loving fiance, laugh-inducing fam, and most importantly, my Heavenly Father, the one I owe all to. I would be lost if it weren't for all of you. Thank you. Our next graduate is Brooks Rock. Brooks is being pinned tonight by his mother, Betsy Rock. And Brooks will be pinned by his mother today. He and his mother will be moving to Connecticut within the next month, where he will start his nursing career at Yale in New Haven Hospital in New Haven, Connecticut. He says, while his dad is not here with him tonight, Brooks knows that he's watching over him on this momentous occasion. Jen Hyan Rowe. Jen is being pinned tonight by his wife, our pianist, Hyun Song. And Jen says, Hyun, my wife, without you, it would be impossible for me to finish nursing school. You have been taking care of our three children while I was in Wichita Falls for school, like you did when I was in Iraq during the war. I thank you for your support, and I love you. Next, I present Jennifer Maxwell Rose. Jennifer is being pinned tonight by her boyfriend, Preston Mitchell, and by her son, Mason Rose. And Jennifer says, I would like to thank my family for all their love and support over the past 2.5 years. I wouldn't have been able to complete this journey without it. I would like to especially thank my son, Mason, for being the joy and desire that has kept me going. And Jennifer has accepted a staff nurse position on Progressive Care Unit 9 West at our United Regional here. Express my joy for your help, for sharing my dreams. my friends, thank you for always putting up with me and rooting for me in my highs and lows. To my family, thank you for your love and support. To my mother, Marilia, and father, Lorenzo, I do not have words to thank you enough. All I can say is gracias los amo. And I even knew how to say that all by myself. Our next graduate is Hassanuddin Sarajlai. Hassanuddin is being pinned tonight by his father, Mohammed Marajuddin Sarajlai, and his mother, Anis Gul. Hassanuddin says, I'd like to thank God for guiding and enabling me to pursue nursing as a career. My parents for their unending love and support. My family for their encouragement. Thank you to my little brother, Amruddin, for the financial support, for without him I couldn't be who I am today. I'd also like to thank my close friends, Maza Aguido, Jen Rowe, and especially my best friend, Betty Amari, for motivating me every day to continue. Being around you guys has made me the person I am. And he has accepted a position as a staff nurse in cardiology and on a medical surgical unit at Methodist Hospital. Our next graduate is Katie Ray Shaw. Katie is being pinned by her husband, Jordan Shaw, and by her son, Brady. Katie would like to thank her parents, Keith and Greta, her in-laws and other family members for always being there to help with their son, Brady. She would like to thank her husband, Jordan, and son, Brady, for being her motivation to never give up. I wouldn't be where I am today without my family. And Katie has been accepted into the emergency room internship program at our United Regional. Society. She would thank her family and friends for being the constant encouragement and push to get her here today. She would specifically like to thank her mom for taking the many phone calls and for reminding her God always has a plan. Kimberly has been accepted into the Emergency Department Nurse Residency Program at Baylor All Saints in Fort Worth. Next, I'd like to present Natasha Stevens. Natasha is being pinned tonight by her mother, Doris, and her sister, Kai. And Natasha says, first, I must thank God for allowing me to make it through this nursing program. I also want to thank my mom and sister for being there to catch every tear, comfort every worry, lift every spirit, encourage in every moment, and rejoice in every overcome obstacle. This is one of my biggest accomplishments, and I have to truly thank you both for being there along this difficult but rewarding journey. Next, I'd like to present Amy Tomez. Says, I wanted to thank my mother and father for giving me the utmost support from the very beginning and helping me throughout this emotional journey. I am beyond grateful for all the teachers that dedicated their time and knowledge in helping us reach our goal of becoming a nurse. And most importantly, glory to God. And Amy has been accepted into an operating room internship at Baylor & White in Waxahachie. Next, I present Andrea June Tatum. Andrea is being pinned tonight by her mother, Laurie Tatum, and by her dad, Tim. And Andrea says, I want to thank my amazing family, fiance, and nursing family for loving and supporting me throughout this journey. I couldn't have done this without each and every one of you. It is true, difficult roads often lead to beautiful destinations. And Andrea has accepted an oncology position at Dallas Methodist. Next, I present Blair Larice Untalan. Blair is being pinned tonight by her mother, Lori, and her father, Greg. And Blair says, God has truly blessed me with the most amazing family and friends who have had faith in me even when I didn't have faith in myself. With y'all's support, my dream profession is coming true. I'm ready to not only become a nurse, but become a support system. A shoulder when needed, a gentle touch, and someone who would do everything in my power to prove I care for every one of my patients. And Blair has accepted a position in CDU observation at Harris Methodist in Fort Worth. Michelle Williams. Kennedy would like to thank first and foremost her Heavenly Father for equipping her with the ability to successfully complete this program. Kennedy is forever grateful for her family and friends, for their love, continuous support, and encouragement have been instrumental in her success. Lastly, she would like to thank the nursing faculty for their involvement in making this day possible. And she has accepted a position with Hendrick Medical Center in Abilene in the NICU. Our last graduate tonight is Adriana Williams. Williams and her mother, Diana Mosley. Adriana says, nursing has been the hardest but most rewarding thing I've ever done. I owe it all to God. It was not any doing of my own. He has truly been a mind regulator, way maker, and a keeper. Thanks to God, my family, and to my true friends who supported and uplifted me throughout my journey, I look forward to the next adventure that God has for me. Fun to watch them graduate tomorrow. If y'all will have a seat for a minute, we'd like to take a moment and share a special surprise with the class, with the faculty and staff, and also with all of the guests here. Stephanie, would you please join me at the pinning table? A little birdie named Steve emailed me a couple times and asked for a favor to pin you. So that's what we're going to do.
Introducing Professor Stephanie Baker, being pinned by Mary Jo Distel, RN, Wilson School of Nursing faculty member. Professor Baker has never been actually pinned as a nurse due to her family having to move because of her husband Steve's career. He's an Air Force pilot currently stationed at Stepford Air Force Base here in Wichita Falls. Professor Baker graduated from an accelerated BSN program from East Carolina University in 2010. This allowed her to take the NCLEX exam and she became licensed as an RN. She went to work as a nurse at Vidant Medical Center in Greenville, North Carolina. During that time, she went to graduate school and earned her master's in nursing education from East Carolina University in 2014. Shortly after that, she joined the Wilson School of Nursing as a full-time faculty member and started teaching the nursing pharmacology course. MSU and Wilson School of Nursing are lucky to have her, and it is a pleasure to pin her tonight with her school colors, purple and gold. Congratulations, Professor Baker.
I solemnly pledge myself before God and in the presence of the assembly with the full knowledge of the responsibilities I am undertaking, faithfully practice my profession of nursing. I will do all in my power to make and maintain the highest standards and practices of my profession. I pledge to care for my patients with all the knowledge, skills, and understanding that I possess, without regard to race, color, creed, politics, or social status. I will spare no effort to conserve meaningful life, to alleviate suffering, and to promote health. I will refrain from any action which might be harmful to the quality of life or health of those I care for. I will respect at all times the dignity and religious beliefs of patients under my care. I will hold in confidence all personal matters committed to my keeping in the practice of my calling. I will endeavor to keep my professional knowledge and skills at the highest level and give my support and cooperation to all members of the healthcare team. I will fulfill my rights and privileges as a good citizen and take my share of responsibility promoting health and welfare of the community. I will seek to nurse those who are ill wherever they may be and whenever they are in need. I will be active in assisting others in safeguarding and promoting health and happiness of mankind through the nursing. Please extinguish your candles and return to your seat.
Thank you. get a lot, God the way. And I don't pay my rent, God the way. There be one for my hand, but God the way. There be one keep my joy, but God the way. I say anything them do, now God the way. No, now God the way. No, now God the way. I don't change my name to God.
For the Roe family, thank you.
who are playing so beautiful music all night tonight. To Professor Baker, who is our keynote speaker.
Jesus. Amen. Amen. Thank you all for coming tonight, and we will see you tomorrow morning at graduation.